Spring has sprung, and the great outdoors beckons for Chris Mullin. But while gardening now takes up a great deal of his time, the issues of the day are never far from the mind of this former MP. Now Mr. Mullin has published a novel set a few years into Brexit Britain. The Friends of Harry Perkins picks up directly from his 1980s political thriller, A Very British Coup.
I wrote the original 37 years ago, and people have been on at me ever since to write a sequel. And after the lapse of a mere 37 years, I finally got round to it.
The Friends of Harry Perkins is a mix of fact and fiction. Chris Mullin takes inspiration from his years at Westminster, including time as a minister.
I'm helped by the fact that I spent 23 years in Parliament, some of it in government, so I do have a feel, I like to think anyway, for how things work on the inside. The novel is set about 5 years ahead of where we are today, so there's an element of prediction in it. One of the reasons A Very British Coup did so well is because many of the things that are in the novel as speculation came to pass. It remains to be seen in this case whether the Friends of Harry Perkins is quite so prescient. But let's wait and see.
A Very British Coup told the story of a socialist MP who leads Labour to general election victory, but soon finds bigger forces working against him. Just a few years after publication, the fictional Prime Minister was powerfully portrayed on screen by Ray McAnally. That TV dramatisation was one reason for the story's global success.
Why do you always insist on travelling second class, Mr. Perkins?
I meet a better class of person that way. You're a perfect example.
Do you intend to abolish first class rail travel, as some reports have been?
No, we will abolish second class rail travel. I think all people are first class. Don't you?
My Prime Minister, Harry Perkins, was brought to life by that wonderful, great actor, Ray McAnally, who sadly died not long afterwards.
How keen would you be to see the Friends of Harry Perkins dramatised on our screens before too long?
Oh, I'm very keen to see it dramatised. I have been talking to a few filmmakers, but nobody's made an offer yet, but it's early days.
The turbulence of current politics seems a long way from Chris Mullin's peaceful surroundings. But for this former MP, it provided the inspiration for a sequel almost 40 years in the making. Helen Ford, ITV News, Northumberland.